Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Chapter Basic Principles and Techniques in Organic Chemistry, and we are doing the topic Classification of the Organic Compounds based on their functional group. Hello friends, in the previous lecture we have studied about the classification of the organic compounds based on their structure, and after that we have studied about what is functional group, and now based on that only we are going to discuss about what are the different classifications of the organic compounds based on their functional group. So let us talk about that one. So not only based on the structure we could differentiate or we could classify the organic compounds, but because of the functional groups also we could easily classify the organic compounds. So the functional group plays a very important role to understand what is the chemical property of that particular organic compound, or what would be the structure for that, and many things that we could get to know because of that. So now talking about the classification of the organic compounds, so let us start with the classification first. So this is the thing that I'm going to divide it with, that is I'll discuss about the class of the compounds, or the mainly that compound is known for. That is, the next is functional group, the general formula, and the example, one of the example that I could represent it for that particular class of compound. So starting with the first one, that is there will be numerous of things that I will explain in this case, but let us talk about the few one, that is starting with the alkane. So the alkanes are basically the class of compounds in which we get to know that they are hydrocarbons, and that moreover we could understand that the carbon-carbon single bond has been present in throughout the whole organic compound. So therefore the functional group in that case would be carbon-carbon single bond. And since we are talking about an alkane. Alkane is the one which consists of an alkyl group along with that of an hydrogen. So therefore the general formula of an alkane can be represented as RH, where the R is nothing but the alkyl group, or we could say that that group which consists of the carbon-carbon single bond, and that is the reason the general formula of the alkane has been represented by RH. And talking about the example of it, so any example like that of C2H5 along with the H, it would be basically ethane. So therefore we could write it as C2H6, and that is nothing but ethane. So the functional group is basically, it is the one which is the identity of that particular organic compound, and in this case the identity is nothing but the carbon-carbon single bond, and hence that is basically the functional group. So this is what I have explained over here, and let us talk about the next one. And the next one is basically, you could call it as for alkene. So alkene is basically classified because of the presence of the carbon-carbon double bond. So therefore we could say that the functional group in the alkene is basically the carbon-carbon double bond. So this carbon-carbon double bond represents that the particular organic compound would be basically an alkene, and that's the reason the general formula of an alkene is written in this format, that is RCH double bond CHR. So this, both the alkyl groups can be same also or could be different also, but yes, there is one thing that we should be sure of, that this whole organic compound, when it comes to an alkene, it consists of at least one carbon-carbon double bond. So here it is. And talking about the example of it, it would be very much easy to understand, that is a C2H4. So if I write over here as C2H4, so therefore this would be called as ethene. So now let us talk about the other one. So there are various functional groups that we are going to discuss about, and let us talk about that one by one. And talking about the next one, that is we could call it is for alkyne. So basically an alkyne is known for its carbon-carbon triple bond that has been present in an organic compound, or the molecule of an organic compound. So therefore we could say that that consists of carbon-carbon triple bond. And that's the reason that we could say, and this is a linear shape that it will form because of the sp hybridization. And the example that I could write it over here is R C triple bond C. Either this could be H, or either it could be R dash, and this R dash can be H also. And as well as it indicates that the both the R can be same and the both the R can be different, or both the alkyl group can be different. So let us talk about this one. Then the simple example that we could write it is C2H2. So C2H2 is basically known as ethyne. So therefore we would write it as ethyne. So this is the three things that we have wrote over here, but the functional group doesn't end here. There are various functional groups that we are going to discuss about in this case. So let us talk about the another one. So we could write it for the next one. Again, the this has been divided into basically four parts. That is the one which is the class of the compound, functional group, the general formula, and then the example. So let us talk about the another one, that is for alkyl halide. So the alkyl halides are the class of the organic compounds which indicates that there would be a presence of an halide group that has been in the organic compound. And the halide groups are basically, it is denoted by X, so therefore the functional group is written as X, and this is nothing but the halide. And this halide is basically can be Cl, Br, F, anything, and that's the reason that the general formula when it comes to an alkyl halide, so therefore we could write it as in this way, that is Rx. And let me give you an example. The example of that would be basically methyl bromide. So therefore methyl bromide, or we could write it as CH3Br. So this is an example of an alkyl halide that I have presented, and that's the reason it by looking at the methyl bromide, because it consists of a Br atom that has been attached to the alkyl group, so therefore the main classification of that would be not an alkane, because it doesn't consist of carbon and hydrogen. It consists of bromine atom, and bromine atom comes under the halogen, and that's the reason that X or that Br is nothing but an halide, and hence the overall class of the compound is basically known as alkyl halide. And now let us talk about the another one that we could discuss, and the another one, suppose like that of alkyl cyanide. Suppose so let me tell you this, all the functional group that I am explaining, it is of no there is no sequence. We could give any of the functional group earlier or after that. So let us talk about the alkyl cyanide. So alkyl cyanide is basically also known as nitrile, and they are known because of the presence of the carbon and nitrogen in this form, that is C triple bond N, and this is the main identification of a particular organic compound which consists of CN, and that's the reason that they are called to be alkyl cyanide when CN is been attached to the alkyl group, or when this nitrile group is attached to the alkyl group. So the example of this one would be very much easy to understand. Suppose if I have taken like C2H5CN, so the name of this would be ethyl cyanide, or we could also say it as because it consists of three carbon atoms, so three carbon atoms means in terms of an IUPAC, it would be called as propane, but this is not a propane, this is a nitrile, so therefore this could be also called as ethyl cyanide. So talking about the next one that we have, and talking about the next one, and suppose the next one could be given as nitroalkane. So when it comes to nitroalkane, then the main thing that is, or the functional group that has been attached to the alkane, it would be basically NO2. Obviously it is known as nitro group. So this nitro group, when attached to an alkane, it is represented by the general formula RNO2. So therefore the name of this one, with an example, suppose if I have to give, then this could be given as like CH3NO2. The name of this is basically consist of one methyl group and one that is nitro group, so therefore the name of this is nitromethane. Very easy to understand, because the nitromethane will be a kind of a nitroalkane from which we could classify it, and that is the thing that we should know, that the functional group is basically NO2. So now let us talk about the another functional group, and that the another functional group is basically known as alcohol. So or the class of the compound is basically known as alcohol. And the alcohol is basically identified because of the presence of the OH group. And this OH group, when it comes to an alcohol, so therefore this is called to be hydroxyl group. And this hydroxyl group, when forms a bond with an alkyl group like that of suppose ROH, so therefore this is known as alcohol. So I could take an example like C2H5, so therefore it could be called as C2H5OH, so therefore it would be called as ethanol. Ethanol or ethyl alcohol. So this were the classification that I have discussed over here, and there are different classifications that is also I wanted to explain. So let us talk about the another one, that is That is what I am going to explain. And the starting with the first one, that is the class of the compound is basically phenols. So phenols are basically known because of again the OH group. But this OH groups are not hydroxyl because this OH groups are not attached to aromatic because this OH group is not attached to the alkyl groups, but these groups are attached to the aromatic groups, and hence they are not the hydroxyl groups, but it has OH, but it would be called as a phenolic OH. So therefore, suppose if that is attached to an aromatic compound, so that is the reason the representation or the general formula for those would be written as AROH. And the example is very popular that we know, that is phenol. And that is this is what we have explained. And let us talk about the another one, that is when it comes to that is amine. So amine is the one which consists of a group that is NH2, and that is the functional group of which is also known as amino group. So therefore this is the amino group. And the classification or is based on the representation that we do for it, and that is basically RNH2. Suppose in the case of R, we have substituted like CH3NH2, so therefore it would be called as basically methylamine or methanamine. So therefore the name of this is methanamine. And so this is what we have discussed, and there are also further groups, and let us talk about the next one, that is aldehyde group, or the class of the compounds we see known as aldehydes. So aldehydes are known because of their functional group, that is basically C double bond OH. So these are the aldehyde group, or we could call this as formyl group. And that is the reason that the representation or is done with CHO. Either we could write it in RCHO, or we could write it in this form, that's RC double bond OH. So the both are aldehyde. And let me give an example, like this one, that is CH3CHO. So the name of this would be basically it consists of two carbon atoms, and that's the reason the name of this could be called as ethanol, or when it comes to the common name of this one, then this is called to be acetaldehyde. Well, in terms of an IUPAC name, it is called as ethanol. So this is the thing that we have discussed about the aldehyde, and let us talk about the other one, that is ketones, a class of the organic compounds basically known as ketones, and they are known for the presence of the group like C double bond O, that is a keto group. So this is known as a keto group. So therefore the classification is done. We could also do the general formula for this one, or representation for the keto groups, and they are basically R C double bond O R dash. Talking about the simple example, that is CH3 CO CH3, basically known as acetone, or we could call it as propane 2-ohm. So even that is possible to give this one. So let us discuss about the another one also. So these are the few ones that we have discussed. So let us discuss the another one. So the next one is basically ether. So ether is because known of its that is functional group, that is we could write it over here as this one, that is, as you could see, that is the oxygen atom has been attached to the two different carbon atoms over here, and that is the reason that if alkyl groups are been attached, so therefore that would be called as an ether. So the general formula can be written as this one. So the name of this one could be, let me give an example, that is CH3OC2H5. So the name of this one be called as methoxy ethane. So therefore, according to the IUPAC name, so therefore the name of this is methoxy ethane. And talking about the next one, that is like carboxylic acid. So carboxylic acids are also an important classification of the organic compounds, and in which they are classified because of the functional group, that is C double bond OH. So these are the acidic groups, and basically known as the carbonyl groups and or carboxylic groups that have been attached over here. So that is the thing that we will write the general formula for this one as RCOOH. So this is the the carboxylic group that has been attached over here, and let me give an example like that of HC double bond OH. So this is known as formic acid, while in terms of an IUPC name, this would be called as methanoic acid. So this is what we have discussed, and that is the carboxylic acid is also written, and related to this only, we could substitute this H with an R group, and this would be converted into an ester. So therefore, the next is ester, and ester are known because of that is C double bond O, O, R. This is the group of the ester that we are going to write, or we could write it as C double bond O, O, where this groups would be attached by an alkyl group. So therefore, the classification of this would be done in the while representing it with R C double bond O O R dash. So therefore this is an ester, and let me give an example that is like CH3 C O O CH3. So the name of this is methyl, while that of the other one it consists of two carbon atoms, so making this to be called as methyl ethanoate. So that is the name of this one, and talking about the another one that we have, so this was ester, and talking about the next is anhydrides or acid anhydrides. So let us talk about anhydrides. So they are known because of, even they will have just like the similar to that of the ester group that we have, and it consists of C double bond O along with this again oxygen and C double bond O. So this is the group that it has, and the general formula for this one could be written as R C double bond O O C double bond O R dash. And the example of this one is basically we could write it as CH3 C O OCOCH3. So therefore the name of this would be acetic anhydride. So therefore the name of this is acetic anhydride. So this is what we have did for the another classification, and talking about the last one there are multiple, but if you could talk about the last one, that is sulfonic acids. So sulfonic acids are known because of the presence of SO3H group that has been attached to the organic compound, and the classification or the general formula could be written as RSO3H. So suppose if we have a group, or we have an example like suppose CH3SO3H. So this example is basically it consists of an alkyl group and SO3H group, so therefore this would be a sulfonic acid. But here it is methyl group that has been attached over here, or we could say that the one hydrogen of an methane has been substituted by SO3H group or sulfonic acid group. So therefore the name of this would be methyl sulfonic acid. So this is what we have discussed, and one more is been remaining, and that is amide group. And that amide group are basically known because of that is C double bond O NH2. This is basically known as amido group. So this could be written as in the general formula like R C double bond O NH2. So I would give you an example like this one, that is CH3 C double bond O NH2. So therefore it consists of one methyl group and the rest is amide. So therefore the name of this would be methanamide. So therefore this CH3 C double bond NH2, it is actually, it is not called as methanamide, it is called as ethanamide because of it consists of only two carbon atoms. So therefore, this were the classifications of the organic compounds which were based on the functional group, and that is what I wanted to explain. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video and you have understood this video very clearly. So share this video with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.